Here are three reasons why a la carte pricing won't be happening anytime soon. Number one, programmers don't want to do it, by which I mean companies like Disney, Time Warner, CBS. It's not the pay TV operators, Comcast, DirecTV, that really care about a la carte pricing. It's the programmers. Number two, the pricing doesn't work. Disney doesn't just make money from ESPN. It also makes money from the channels that it ties or bundles together with ESPN. I'm talking about ESPN2, ESPN3, ESPN The Ocho, what have you. Disney makes money from affiliate fees, or the money it charges the pay TV companies to carry those networks, and it makes money from advertising revenue, which is based on how many people are watching the network at a given time. In an a la carte world, fewer people would be watching those lesser channels that are bundled together with ESPN, because you may want ESPN, but you don't necessarily want to watch ESPN3. Number three, it would hurt the cable operator brand. In this world, I would have a relationship with ESPN or Comedy Central, but what I won't have is that relationship with Time Warner Cable or Comcast directly. This may be problematic for the pay TV operators. If I want to buy ESPN, I will buy the ESPN app, which currently resides in a world called TV Everywhere, which forces me to be a cable subscriber. The point I'm trying to make here is that in an ideal world, I would only pay, say, $20 for the four or five channels I want to watch. But in reality, Disney and CBS and Time Warner would make me pay so much money for only those four or five channels that I would end up paying almost as much, and that's why we won't be seeing a la carte pricing anytime soon.